Picture this. You've just spent hundreds of dollars on a custom-built terrarium for your pets. Or maybe you added a brand new houseplant to your collection. You enjoy your new investment for a few days, when suddenly, fungus gnats! And not just a few here and there, fungus gnats everywhere! Hey, what's up, you guys? I'm Tatiana. I'm sitting on the floor here in my tiny zoo, and today we're going to be talking about fungus gnats. To be honest, I've wanted to release this video for a couple months now. I thought fungus gnats were going to be really easy to get rid of, and I could just crank this video out. Boy, was I wrong. After weeks and weeks of fighting them off, I actually have a good idea of what works and what absolutely not to waste your money on. So, without wasting any more time, let's get right into it. The very first thing I tried is sticky traps, and I think this is a go-to for a lot of people, so let's talk about these for a moment. These sticky traps are very cheap and easy to get, and work by sticking to your windows or directly onto terrarium glass, and catching bugs with their glue-like exterior. The thing you should know about fungus gnats is these insects start out as larvae before turning into their winged adult form, and then go on to breed and lay eggs in your soil. Even though sticky traps work great at catching the adult fungus gnat, they take so long to work that the adults have plenty of time to breed and lay hundreds of eggs before getting caught in them. The catchy is also highly recommended as an effective way to get rid of fungus gnats. This works as a plug-in fan that sucks the gnats inside and they get stuck to the glue trap on the bottom. And it has the same issues as regular stick-on glue traps, meaning it'll catch the adult gnats just fine, but it doesn't really break the life cycle. So personally, I wouldn't recommend spending money on these products, or if you do want them, pair them with another gnat removal method that we'll talk about later. Let's move on to the next thing, and that is diatomaceous earth. I tried using it to get rid of fungus gnats by pouring it into containers or onto plates, and then placing them around my terrariums and houseplants. These didn't really do anything. While this method might have killed one or two stray fungus gnats that got caught inside, they really didn't do anything overall. The next thing I tried was hydrogen peroxide. This is a method that I've seen recommended all over houseplant YouTube channels and various Facebook groups that I'm in, but after trying it, it didn't really do anything to fix my infestation. I did a ratio of 4:1, meaning I mixed one part hydrogen peroxide to four parts water. This is supposed to kill any fungus gnat eggs that are in the soil, but even after repeating the process a few times, it didn't really put a dent in their population. Another thing that I see a lot of people recommending online is letting their soil dry out completely or bottom watering their plants so that the top layer gets dry. Fungus gnats thrive in moist soil, so I turned off my Mist King, I interrupted my watering schedule, and I let everything in my reptile room dry out completely for almost 2 weeks. Nothing happened to the gnat population at all, but I did lose a few houseplants and terrarium plants to the drought. This method is absolutely not worth it for me.
The last method I tried before I found my holy grail of fungus gnat problems was parasitic mites. And this is not a frequent solution that I see in the United States, but it is a very common recommendation across the UK and Europe, so I decided to give it a try.
These are mites that you introduce to your terrariums or your houseplants that eat the larva stage of the fungus gnat. I tried this method twice, and let me tell you, it is not cheap. The first round of parasitic mites was advertised to have 12,500 mites total, and the second round, I went all in and I bought 32,000 mites. I sprinkled these guys into pretty much everything I could and waited. And waited. And waited. Over a month I waited, and honestly, 40,000 mites total in my reptile room, I really expected them to put a dent in my fungus gnat population. But nothing. They didn't work at all, so don't waste your money.
Now, I'd just like to take a moment and say that if you are enjoying this video, or if you think this video is going to save you money, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. I put out new videos every week. Finally, we can talk about the product that beats all other products, and that is one of these two. This is mosquito bits. It's very common, easy to find in your local hardware store, or natural. So Natrol is just a powder that you mix in with a gallon of water. And then you water your houseplants or your terrariums every week with this product. And it is a very effective way to remove fungus gnats. It's the only solution that, foolproof, it worked for me. Mosquito bits is the same thing. It's actually coated with natural on the outside of them, but it takes a little bit longer to work because it's not as concentrated. And mosquito bits also can cause mold sometimes on your houseplants or in your terrariums. So if you can, I think this is cheaper. You can buy them in a couple different sizes, and you mix a different concentrations based on how bad your infestation is. My infestation was pretty severe, and this knocked them out. So my final recommendation to you guys is to get either natural or mosquito bits and pair them with these fly traps, because the natural will target the larva and the egg form, and this will target the adults. These two are all you should spend your money on for the fastest fungus gnat relief. That's all I have for you guys today. I hope I helped you with your fungus gnat problems. As always, my name is Tatiana. You're watching My Tiny Zoo, and I put out new videos every week. I'll see you next time.